Assalamu alaikum students, we are going to start with our lesson number 2 of week number 6 starting from 11th of May and ending on 15th of May. We are discussing the last topic of chapter number 2. Chapter number 2 is about painting and master painters of Pakistan. Today's lecture is about Ajanta cave paintings. The objectives of this lecture are that you will be able to define fresco painting, write about historical background of Ajanta cave art, what is Ajanta cave art, explain the main features of Ajanta cave paintings, discuss the process and technique which is used by the Ajanta cave painters to make these paintings, write about the symbolic importance of blue lotus in Buddhism. We're going to start off with the historical background of Ajanta cave paintings. Buddhism emerged as world's great religion in 6th century BC. So the followers of Buddhism showed the life of their religious leader Buddha in the form of sculptures called Gandhara art, and they also showed his life events in the form of fresco mural paintings called Ajanta art. So basically, what is Ajanta art? Ajanta art are the fresco mural paintings painted by the followers of Buddhism, and these paintings were done to show the life events of their religious leader Buddha. Ajanta caves, what is the location of Ajanta caves? Ajanta caves are located in Deccan, India, and these caves are closer to the city of Aurangabad. So this is the location of Ajanta cave paintings. The total number of these caves is 29. They are not natural caves, they are man-made caves. They were built and carved and developed by the followers of Buddhism who are called the monks. And these caves, they cover an area of 600 meters and they are spread in a horseshoe shape. Walls and ceilings of Ajanta caves are decorated with beautiful fresco mural paintings done by followers of Buddhism. So this fresco mural painting technique is the basic technique used for painting the wall and ceiling paintings of Ajanta cave paintings. The basic subject of Ajanta cave art was the life events of Buddha, their religious leader. The other two common subjects are women paintings and animal paintings, along with some very beautiful decorative motifs and patterns. So these paintings are very heavily decorative paintings, and they are basic subject of these paintings was to show the life events of their religious leader Buddha. What was the main subject of Ajanta cave paintings? You have been introduced to this earlier, that the main theme the main subject in Ajanta cave painting is the life events of Buddha. The other two common subjects were women painting and animal paintings. Lots of decorative patterns were also painted in these cave paintings, and beautiful frames were added around the paintings. Ajanta cave paintings used painters used earth colors and bristle brushes to paint these fresco paintings. So what material the artists used? They used earth colors and bristle brushes. Bristle brushes means rough brushes to paint these fresco murals. Fresco technique used by Ajanta cave painters involved the use of wet lime plaster as a base. On this wet plaster, the artist used to draw and paint beautiful mural paintings. So this technique was introduced to the subcontinent from the Greek people, and from Greek people, the local artists of the subcontinent learned this technique of mural painting, which involves the painting on wet lime plaster by using earth colors and bristle brushes. What was the basic technique of Ajanta cave painting? Ajanta cave painting technique is called fresco painting technique, and this painting technique evolved from Greek areas, and from Greek artists, the local artists learned this technique. Following steps were involved in the painting of these wall paintings or fresco murals. The first step is that they used to smooth the surface of the walls by burnishing it with stone. So they used to have a stone and rub the stone on the wall surfaces to make the wall smooth. Then a mixture of clay and straw was applied on the wall so it became thick and soft. So first of all, they made the wall smooth by burnishing it or rubbing it with a stone. Then they applied a mixture of clay and straw so that it became thick and soft. Finally, lime plaster was applied, and then the drawing was done on wet lime plaster with some dark color like black or red, make an outline of the painting or the images they wanted to paint. Then earth colors were applied on wet plaster. As they dried, they got firm and fixed to the wall. Once the painting was dry, it was polished once again to add shine to its surface. So these were all the steps involved or techniques involved in painting the Ajanta cave paintings. What were the main features? The main features of Ajanta cave painting are that they were decorative element was very strong in these paintings. Beautiful frames were added around the cave painting. The roof were also divided into blocks, and floral and geometric designs and patterns were designed, were made on them. Dark outline was very prominent. So it is the most prominent feature of Ajanta cave paintings. The figures and main areas had dark outlines around them. Ajanta cave painting had a feeling of depth and perspective in them. Some figures were painted in the foreground and some were at the background, so you had a feeling of depth in the painting. Another feature is the effect of peace and calmness. No war painting or bloodshed was painted in scenes were painted in Ajanta cave paintings. Use of light and dark color against each other is a very creative was done very creatively and beautifully. So they used to paint, if the figures were painted in light color, they used to paint the backgrounds in dark color. That's how they brought forward the contrast between the light and dark colors. In Ajanta cave paintings, figures were painted in proper proportion, closer to the nature. As they appear in nature and in their original form, that's how they also painted them in the Ajanta cave paintings. Ajanta cave paintings are painted with beautiful and vibrant earth colors. So they used all the natural colors and tones for the painting these paintings. Ajanta cave paintings show life in full bloom, and human figures and animals were painted in such a way that they appeared full of life. So they are very closer to life. They are full of life paintings. The main purpose of Ajanta cave painting was to paint the life events of Buddha. And their religious leader and artist have depicted Buddha as a prince, and also they depicted him as a religious leader in different paintings showing his life events. Buddha with blue lotus. What is this, the significance or importance of blue lotus? This painting is found in Ajanta cave number 1, and in this painting Buddha is shown seated in a very dignified pose and half closed eyes, straight nose and big ears. These are all the features which were painted again and again to show Buddha. Half closed eyes, straight nose, big ears. His face was painted with the expression of seriousness and majestic looks. In this painting, Buddha is painted with jewelry. So this means that he is painted as a prince. Wherever Buddha is painted with the jewelry, this means that he is painted as a prince or shown as a prince. Wherever he is not wearing jewelry, this means he is shown as a religious leader. He is holding a blue lotus flower in his right hand. The upper half of his body is naked, lower half is covered with a draped dress. The facial expression or the face features used and the use of blue lotus flower is a symbol to show Buddha as a pious and prominent figure. So blue lotus was used as a main symbol to show Buddha as a religious leader. Symbolic importance of blue lotus. The blue lotus in Buddhism is the symbol of victory of spirit over senses, victory of intelligence and wisdom, and victory of knowledge. It represents perfection of wisdom. So blue lotus represents what? It represents perfection of wisdom of Buddha. In relation with Buddha, the blue lotus flower represents his wisdom and piousness. So his religious importance, his wisdom and his piousness was represented by the symbol of blue lotus. How Ajanta cave paintings declined. In 470 CE, white Huns attacked the area of Gandhara and destroyed everything. They burned their monasteries, they destroyed these caves also. So heavy damage was done to all the arts and crafts belonging to Gandhara civilization. Buddhism declined and Hinduism started to flourish in this region. Ajanta cave paintings are considered as the golden period of painting in the subcontinent because they are extremely beautiful. Paintings closer to life, and the artists were very skillful in painting these fresco mural paintings. As Hinduism spread in the subcontinent, lots of sculptures and temples were made in the area, and Ajanta cave painting declined. सो व्हाट हैव यू लर्न्ड अबाउट अजंता के पेंटिंग? दैट अजंता के पेंटिंग बिलोंग टू गंधारा सिविलाइजेशन. दीज पेंटिंग्स आर मेड बाय द फॉलोअर्स ऑफ बुद्धिज्म, बाय द फॉलोअर्स ऑफ बुद्धिज्म हु फॉलोड देयर रिलीजियस लीडर कॉल्ड बुद्धा. एंड दे आर मेड बाय यूजिंग फ्रेस्को म्यूरल पेंटिंग टेक्निक. द केव्स आर कार्व्ड बाय बुद्धिस्ट मॉन्क्स. दे आर नॉट मैन मेड caves. They are located in Dakkan, India. Total number is 29. They are spread in horseshoe shape and they cover an area of 600 meters. Main subject of Ajanta cave painting is the life events of Buddha. Other common subjects are paintings of women, animals and lots of decorative motifs. Basic technique involves painting with earth colors on and bristle brushes on wet lime plaster. As the plaster dries, the painting becomes a part, integral part of the wall. Main features of Ajanta cave painting includes decorative elements, dark outline, depth, proportion, use of light, dark light and dark colors, then peace and harmony, life events of Buddha. So all of these are main features of Ajanta cave paintings. In 470 CE, while white Huns attacked this area of Gandhara and destroyed everything, Buddhism declined and Hinduism flourished in the area. So these are the slides, some of the slides of Ajanta cave paintings. Look how it is all filled up with figures. They are female figures, they are dancing over here. Then there is some main figure, this is the figure of Buddha sitting over here. So this is the foreground of the painting, the background of the painting, use of light and dark colors. The figures are all in light color, the background is in dark color. These are the examples of the some pillars over there. There is this Buddha is standing over here. Then some of the images of Buddha sitting over here with a halo behind his head and the crepe cloth around him, sitting in a yogic pose with the hands on his lap and crossed legs. All these are the symbols used to represent Buddha. You can recognize that this is Buddha because these symbols are repeated again and again wherever Buddha is painted. And he has no jewelry over here, so he is shown as a religious leader. So every inch of these caves are covered with paintings, and vibrant earth colors and bristle brushes were used. This is another example. Look how vibrant the colors are and how light and dark colors are used. The figures are all in light color, the background is in dark color. This is the foreground of the painting, this is the background of the painting. How they have used the natural form and figures of elephants. They are very closer to nature. Human figures are also very closer to nature. And this is Buddha sitting in the center. He is in a big, his size is a little bigger, so he is more prominent. He has a halo behind the head. And how he is preaching his teachings to his followers or monks. This is the horseshoe shape model of the Ajanta caves. They are 29 in number. They are spread in a horseshoe shape or a U shape, and the number is 29. Total number of caves is 29. They are located near the city of Aurangabad, Dakkan, India. So this is an example of animal painting. So these are very closer to the nature, how they appear, how they have looked and observed the animals. And look, there is a border at the base. There's a floral border in the base of this painting. This is a painting of women, how they use decorative motifs and their jewelry and motifs on their clothes, and the beautiful features of these women. Some are playing flutes, one of the figures is dancing. So this is very closer to nature, and all the features are very beautifully painted in these paintings. So I hope you have understood everything about Ajanta cave paintings, and go through the resource and attempt all the MCQs, short questions and log questions properly. Thank you, and Allah Hafiz.